Bota Brothers! Family Bota!
Family Bota!
I'm staring out into the night, trying to hide the pain. I'm going to the place where love and feeling good don't ever cost a thing. And the pain you feel's a different kind of pain.
David, this is God, again, speaking to you, from the holy heaven. I want you to know, that, when you were born, I have placed in your heart, a few very special seeds, which will only sprout, on a divine soil. If you will try to plant them on a bad soil, those seeds will rotten, and be lost, forever. I am now going to show you, the top 400 gardens of the world, also called world universities, where you should go, plant those seeds, and let them sprout, grow, and flourish. I would especially recommend you, any of the Canadian gardens listed there, not only because you are a Canadian yourself, but also because, with the degrees obtained from those universities, you could get a job, almost, anywhere in the world. Do not ever forget that, if you do not choose those gardens, you may end up, on infected gardens, with infected soils, and evil gardeners, who would destroy your seeds, break your soul, cut your wings, and transform you into evil, and beasts, like themselves. Where is Romania? Where are the Romanian universities? Why don't they appear on those world university rankings? Is there something wrong? Based on the huge Romanian ego and the big Romanian arrogance, the Romanian university should absolutely be amongst the best in the world. How come they are not placed there to match the Romanian ego? Who made the mistake? Are the people of the civilized world blind or stupid? Or is the Romanian educational system a creepy, stupid, and a despicable one? What is the truth? Do Romanian universities exist? Are they classified? If they are, where are they? Do Romanian universities really match the big Romanian ego, or is that ego based on plain Romanian communist ignorance and stupidity? Are those rankings wrong? Or are the Romanian universities so corrupted, so stupid, so badly stinking, so badly smelling, and so insignificant that they don't really count in today's world? What is the truth? The answer to those questions is not hard to find. Anyone can go to the internet and Google World University Rankings and discover the truth for themselves. All the wise and the highly educated people of the civilized world know that the Romanian educational system is filled with professors that are arrogant, execrable, repulsive, imbecile, and evil. They also know that Romanian professors cannot teach knowledge, skills, or wisdom, since their hearts are evil and don't have the educational credentials or the professional competence to do it. How could they teach honesty, integrity, humility, freedom, democracy, or civilization, since they have no understanding of those basic concepts? How could they do something they never learned, they never believed in, and they cannot understand? While the Romanian educational system is filled with this type of crooked, sickening and detestable professors, the educational system in the civilized world is filled with honest, humble, bright and brilliant professors. If the Romanian professors are manipulatively creating a classroom environment of a predatory nature where they could do anything they want, including humiliating, abusing, harassing, and sexually exploiting their students, the professors teaching in the universities of the civilized world are doing just the opposite by always creating an open, free, uniform, dignifying, and stimulating environment where their students could learn, grow, and develop. If the imbecile Romanian predatory professors would always act as gods, continuously cutting their students' wings or breaking their students' souls, the professors of the civilized world will always help their students grow strong wings to be able to fly and soar high in the sky. The Romanian educational system is neither humane nor is it civilized. It is stinking, nauseating, repulsive, horrible, and stupid. Since the Romanian professors are evil and only know how to do evil, what their pupils could learn from them is all evil. The Romanian educational system could fool the ignorant Romanian masses, but it cannot fool the bright, the honest, and the humble people of the civilized world. No wonder the Romanian doctors, judges, and all the other Romanian university graduates are predatory evils. What the Romanian university professors are teaching is not knowledge, nor is the truth. They teach lies, deceptions, exploitations, and manipulations. How they are teaching in those universities is primitive, inhumane, abusive, and wrong. What Romanians are saying about their universities is false, totally false. What they say about their education is a lie as big as is their infected, nauseating, and stinking Romanian ego. Just pause and think for a minute. How could a person, any person of this world, call themselves educated after learning and discovering the truth? The truth about what is right and what is wrong, about what is good and what is bad, about what is just and what is unjust, yet not be able to see what is happening in their country, Romania. How could they call themselves educated if they don't react or fight to stop the evil that is happening in Romania? How could an educated person see the wrongs and the injustices that have brought so much pain and sufferings into their country and not react? How come the wrong, the bad, and the evils are not being stopped, arrested and judged, and why are they still allowed to lead Romania? How come the evils who are responsible for all those Romanian atrocities are still allowed to be, to stay, to control, and to destroy that country? Are the Romanian university graduates educated to see the truth, the good, and the humane? Or are they educated to be predatory themselves, like the evils who taught them? Furthermore, many Romanian university graduates have never went a day to school. Some of them fraudulently bought their degrees from the crooked university leaders, while others did go to school from time to time, but never bothered to learn. They bought their grades either by offering sex or by giving money. Imagine now how many of those imbecile graduates went on and later acted as Romanian judges and destroyed the poor and the innocent people by selling their verdicts to the guilty criminals, or as medical doctors and killed the sick, the suffering, and the innocent people of Romania. Imagine what could they learn from their professors and how much those university graduates who are now controlling the political power in Romania know about learning, about honesty, or about integrity. Open your eyes and look at each and every one of them. The dirt, the injustices, the stinky smell, and the sexual abuses happening throughout the Romanian educational system is so despicable, execrable, and sickening that the people of the civilized world could not even imagine. The Romanian superior education system is now teaching its students on how to become predators. All the jobs those graduates would take are of bureaucratic nature, and nobody's surprised to see predatory bureaucrats everywhere, no matter if you go to a doctor, a judge, or a teacher. If Romanian universities would teach knowledge, skills, democracy, or civilization, their university would be listed in the top world universities, but as anybody can see, they are not listed. That means Romanian universities are not good. By looking at the injustices, corruption, and the crimes happening throughout the justice system, the health system, or the educational system, one could easily see those institutions are all run by predators educated in the Romanian universities. How could anyone expect freedom, democracy, or civilization when the people leading those institutions are ignorant, dishonest, arrogant, hypocrites, coward, parasites, scumbags, and predatory criminals? What is happening in Romania is shocking, shameful, and disgusting. These criminal predators are continuously screaming and yelling that Romania has the smartest people and the best education in the world, yet anybody could see that Romania's education is amongst the worst in the world. All what Romanian students learn in the superior educational system is how to become predators. Sexual predators, criminal predators, material predators, and all the other forms of predators there might exist in this world. There is no true education in Romania. There is no justice in Romania. There is no freedom, democracy, or civilization in Romania. There is no humanity, integrity, or compassion in Romania. There is nothing good in Romania. The leaders of the Romanian educational system are delusional, poisonous, and some of the most despicable, repulsive, and disgusting people in the world. They are the shame of education in the world. What Romanians are calling education has nothing to do with education, but rather with learning on how to become a predator, a crook, a thief, and a scam bag, like these cockroach professors who have destroyed the spirit and the very future of this nation. To make the Romanian education count in today's world, one has to start by first cutting the head of the snake. The head of the Romanian snake are not only the professors who have received their poisonous education under the infected communist regime, but also those who have learned from those crooked, evil, and delusional professors. All those who learn the lessons taught by the infected commies have become infected as well. To cut the head of the snakes means to get rid of them all. They are all infected, they are all poisonous, and they all stink. To cut the head of the snake, it means to get rid and replace all Romanian educated leaders with people educated in the free, democratic, and civilized world. This may take decades, but it is the only option. The Romanian cockroach predators will hide, lie, and con everybody, trying to keep their chairs as long as they could. But if Romanians want civilization throughout their land, this is the first thing they have to do. David, in 1996, your father went to Bucharest to the Ministry of Education, requesting an accreditation to his university degrees. When the Romanian bureaucrats running that ministry saw your father's degrees, they started laughing and saying that those two degrees were too small and too insignificant. Your father was shocked hearing that, because he just taught the previous 2 years at the University of Ottawa and saw the corruption, the lies, the cheats, the deceits, and all the other disastrous things happening, not only at that university, but throughout the whole Romanian educational system. David, look. Your father's degrees were issued by a university ranked 188 in the world, yet, those scam bags and poisonous bureaucrats leading the Romanian educational system said his degrees were too small and too insignificant for a country that has an education ranked amongst the lowest in the world. What other proof does one need to show to the world how arrogant, ignorant, repulsive, and stupid are the Romanian educational leaders? David, what is ironic about this is not only that your father came with an education received from a university ranked on the top 188 in the world to Romania, a country with the lowest education in the world, but your father had also studied at that university the psychological profiles of winners and losers from two of the top world scholars in sports psychology, Terry Orlick and John Somela. He saw those cockroach Romanian professors working at the Ministry of Education and throughout the Romanian universities fitting the psychological profile of evil, detestable, despicable, disgusting, sickening, repulsive, and stinky losers. So, David, your option is to either take your seeds to the stinky and putrid gardens in Romania and lose them, or to the fertile gardens in Canada, where they will sprout, grow, and develop. By going to Canada, you will be free, you will be respected, and you will be able to grow strong wings, and fly high in the sky. The options are yours.
Descins azi dimineață la 22 de adrese din București, Ilfov, Vâlcea și Olt. În vizorul anchetatorilor se află mai multe cadre didactice ale Universității Bioterra suspectate de fapte de corupție și fals. Percheziții au loc și la sediul central al Universității Bioterra, dar și la locuința unui profesor universitar din Vâlcea.
Nu a fost chemat până în momentul de față niciun cadru didactic. În mod normal ar trebui să fiu chemat și eu în calitate de rector.
Ce veți face dacă veți fi pus sub acuzare?
Trebuie să răspund, să vedem despre ce e vorba. Chiar nu știu cu ce aș putea fi acuzat. Există pe rolul Tribunalului Vâlcea un dosar în care este învinuit un cadru didactic de la Universitatea Bioterra pentru fapte de corupție. Am înțeles că se află la domiciliu unde locuința este percheziționată.
Ministrul Educației Caterina Andronescu spune că a cerut deja un control la Universitatea Bioterra.
O să trimitem și noi corpul de control acolo să vedem ce s-a întâmplat. Nu cred că trebuie să-i apreciem, ci dimpotrivă, dacă lucrurile se verifică și așa sunt, cred că trebuie să-și primească pedeapsa meritată. Nu ne putem juca cu școala.
La rândul său, fostul ministru al educației Liviu Pop spune că și studenții au partea lor de vină în acest scandal.
Trist este că avem încă studenți la aceste universități. Studenți care ar trebui să se intereseze în prima fază dacă acea instituție la care să se scrie este sau nu este acreditat.
Acțiunea este coordonată de procurorii parchetului de pe lângă Tribunalul Vâlcea împreună cu ofițeri de poliție judiciară din cadrul Serviciului de Investigare a Fraudelor Vâlcea.
Anchetatorii au făcut astăzi 19 percheziții și mai bine de 40 de persoane au fost duse la audieri. În fapt, doi profesori de la Universitatea Bioterra și alți 5 salariați ai universității sunt cercetați pentru fals și corupție.
Anchetatorii au controlat toate secretariatele facultăților de la Universitatea Bioterra. Rectorul universității spune că unul dintre profesorii vizați este angajat de 3 ani la Facultatea de Control și Expertiză Alimentară.
Există pe rolul Tribunalului Vâlcea un dosar în care este învinuit un cadru didactic de la Universitatea Bioterra pentru fapte de corupție. În afara acestor date s-au mai cerut date despre actuali sau foști studenți, deci absolvenți. Căutăm în momentul de față să identificăm.
Rectorul Bioterra spune că a aflat abia acum despre caz, promite verificări. Controle vor face și specialiștii din Ministerul Educației.
Pentru că noi să avem propriile noastre clarificări, am constituit deja o echipă de control, pleacă deja de acolo și o să stea acolo până când aducem la lumină toate aspectele legate de activitatea academică de acolo. Adică dacă procedurile sunt legale, dacă notele se registrează în catalog, în registrul matricol și în suplimentul la diplomă în mod corect.
Universitatea Bioterra a fost implicată și în urmă cu 12 ani într-un scandal asemănător. Atunci Ministerul Educației i-a retras autorizația pentru că ar fi organizat ilegal filiale ale unor facultăți în țară. Apoi a emis diplome cu parafa Ministerului, fără să aibă acest drept. În 2009, Universitatea a primit calificativul grad de încredere limitat în urma evaluării. Potrivit raportului Aracis, s-a constatat că la începutul facultății erau înscriși 50 de studenți, dar absolveau de 4 ori mai mulți.
Audierile în cazul diplomelor de licență obținute pe bani continuă și la această oră.
La sediul Inspectoratului General al Poliției Române au fost aduse 20 de persoane implicate în acest caz. Caz urmărit și de colegul nostru, Marius Popescu. Marius, bună ziua! Ce ai reușit să afli despre acuzațiile aduse profesorilor universitari?
Bună ziua, doamnelor și domnilor. Vorbim practic de o anchetă ce s-a desfășurat pe două paliere. Vorbim în primul rând de faptul că exista un întreg sistem de SMS-uri, de mesaje text. Studenții trimiteau acele mesaje către cadre didactice și apoi primeau efectiv rezultatele și răspunsurile la întrebări. Urma ca în săptămâna respectivă să desfășoare un examen. Totdeauna acel examen era un test grilă, astfel încât unii dintre studenți știau deja răspunsurile, iar în momentul în care se prezentau în sala de examen era imposibil să nu o promoveze. Pe de altă parte, există și ancheta legată de diplomele de licență, diplome din ceea ce spun sursele noastre, emise în baza, evident, a unor sume de bani, astfel încât cei care nu prea aveau chef să învețe sau pur și simplu nu erau în stare să iau o diplomă de licență, dădeau acești bani și apoi obțineau certificatul prin care se arăta că au absolvit o facultate. Din ceea ce am aflat noi, se pare că este o problemă destul de mare la Facultatea de Industrie Alimentară din cadrul acestei universități, însă și alte facultăți sunt verificate în prezent de autorități. Ancheta este condusă de către procurori de la parchetul Vâlcea, sunt și polițiști de la IPJ Vâlcea, dar sunt implicați și polițiști de aici, din București. De altfel, s-au efectuat peste 20 de percheziții, 18 dintre acestea efectuându-se strict la sediul Universității Biotera.
David,
de ce se ocupă până
as
la
you can see, everywhere you look, in Romania, you will see corruption. Life in Romania is so heinous, it's so vile, odious, wicked, atrocious, detestable, despicable, execrable, nauseating, disgusting and sickening that you can't even take it in. Everything that is happening throughout the Romanian educational system is crooked, dishonest, disgusting and dirty. Everybody that goes through and gets out from that system of education is already infected and will do evil because that's all he learned. All great things in life start from a good education. If a country has despicable, execrable, and predatory university professors, that country will end up having predatory leaders, and those evil leaders will end up totally destroying the people of that nation. David, you have two options. The first option is to remain in that country and learn from those predators and end up becoming a predatory loser yourself. The second option is to leave that country and all that evil behind and come to Canada, the country of freedom, democracy and civilization. By going through the Canadian educational system, you will be learning the values of honesty, integrity, and love, as opposed to the predatory instincts you may get by living and going through the infected Romanian educational system. David, Canada is as far ahead of the uncivilized Romania as your father's love towards you is from that of your mother's. You have been kept in lies, deceits and abuses, and the time has come for you to leave that hell behind. You should leave behind all the pain, the sufferings, and the abuses you had to go through, not only from your evil keepers, but also from your imbecile teachers and criminal doctors.
Universității Eftimie Murgu din Reșița este Doina Frunză Verde, soția liderului PNL, fost PDL, Sorin Frunză Verde. Universitatea din Reșița a obținut cel mai mic punctaj în topul integrității realizat de Coaliția pentru Universități Curate.
David, this is the university and it's corrupted head. Your mother chose to go to get rid of you and your infant brother, Daniel, and get her useless, disgusting and insignificant education instead of letting you and your infant brother be raised by your father, she cunningly, crookedly, and dishonestly took you away from him and placed you into the hands of her diabolical mother, the evil Orthodox priestess Delia. Instead of choosing a university that was closer to you, her children, in Via Maria, she chose this one. In Oradea, which was much further from you, from which she could not come to see you for months and months at the time. She chose that university mainly because that university was more corrupted, more disgusting, and much dirtier than the one closer to you. So, she went to a university where anybody could buy their degrees, their grades, or their entries with either money or sex. As you already know, you never had money because your mother has never had enough money. Her parents have paid in the past for her crooked, dishonest, and fraudulent entry, and it happened just before you were born. Your father has taught at that university a few years earlier, and you were shocked to discover the numerous abuses, corruption, and injustices that were happening at every level of that institution. So, David, this is where your mother went. This is the university your mother chose to go and waste her time instead of being close, giving maternal love and taking care of her children's childhood.
Contractul, dar dai și tu partea. Este un model după care se lucrează nu doar în primării, ci și în sediile unor instituții de învățământ de elită. Universitatea de Medicină Carol Davila din Capitală a fost astăzi perchiziționată de anchetatori care suspectează că multe dintre contractele încheiate de conducere cu anumite firme sunt ilegale, pentru că au fost obținute cu șpagă.
Directorul administrativ al Universității de Medicină din București este, spun procurorii, coordonatorul afacerii cu ispenali. Din funcția pe care o avea vreme de 4 ani, ar fi atribuit preferențial contracte de achiziții unor oameni de afaceri pe care îi cunoștea. Vorbim despre 9 firme. În schimb, trebuia, susțin anchetatorii, să primească înapoi numai puțin de 40% din valoarea lucrărilor. Șpaga nu era însă fixă, ci negociabilă. Fiind vorba de contracte de până în 10.000 de euro, atribuirea era directă. Nici reprezentanții universității și nici cei firmelor incriminate nu au făcut vreun comentariu pe această temă.
Pe principiul dai banul, ei contractul ar fi fost reabilitate printre altele și 4 cămine pentru studenți care aparțin de Universitatea de Medicină Carol Davila. Valoarea contractelor se ridică la peste 1.000.000 de lei. Astfel, spun anchetatorii, suspecții din dosar ar fi primit un comision de 150.000 de euro în schimbul bunăvoinței lor.
La fel ar fi procedat și pentru reabilitarea Facultății de Medicină Generală sau a celei de Medicină Dentară. De trafic de influență, spălare de bani, luare și dare de mită. 6 persoane au fost duse cu mandat la audieri.
Percheziții la Universitatea de Medicină și Farmacie din București.
Sunt cercetate infracțiuni de abuz în serviciu, uz de fals, luare și dare de mită.
Marius Popescu are mai multe informații despre această desfășurare de forțe. Marius, bun găsit! Vorbim despre zeci de percheziții în 3 județe și în capitală.
Percheziții la cel mai mare spital din vestul țării.
Ofițerii de la antifraudă au căutat dovezi într-un dosar de corupție.
Este anchetat modul în care a fost condiționat actul medical și cum erau primite sponsorizările. Pacienții dădeau bani către un ONG sub formă de donații.
Au fost făcute percheziții la clinica de chirurgie vasculară a Spitalului Județean de Urgență din Timișoara, dar și la locuința șefului clinicii, medicul Mihai Ionac. Detalii ne oferă de la Timișoara.
When you hear me talk about Romania, as the expression goes, you cut your teeth, right? This was how I learned about adoption. Sorry. I haven't talked about this in a long time. It was the most unreal experience that I've ever had in my life. It's so heinous. It's so vile that you can't even take it in. I felt nauseous and faint. Almost like guilty for even being there. And I've never seen that anywhere except Romania.
David, when your father started studying at the University of Ottawa, which, as you could see, is ranked 188 in the world, he had many difficulties. In the fall of 1989, when he was in his first semester as a full-time student, he took 5 courses and he failed 3 of them. That was not only because he didn't speak English very well, but rather because he discovered his true ignorance in the subjects of math and chemistry. He was, at that time, a typical Romanian young man, dishonest, crooked, and very, very arrogant. Those feelings courses truly affected him. Your father was already 32 years old and wanted to quit. That was the U-turn in his life. That's when he turned his life around. He then decided to forget everything he learned from Romania and start learning what he was taught there. He started learning hard and working hard and turned his life around. Slowly and slowly, he got rid of his arrogance and stopped being lazy, dishonest, and crooked. Slowly and slowly, he changed himself to the mentality of the people living in Canada and in the rest of the civilized world. His hard work and his newfound honesty and integrity helped him overcome those early course feelings, and he finished his 4 years university degree in 3 years and then his 2 years of master's in just 9 months. The reason I am saying this to you, David, is to inform you that you could also do it. You could go to any university in the world and you could study anything you want in the world. Your only concern should be whether the university you are going to is respecting the values of true learning or not. A good university in the world is ranked high if its students truly learn the subjects they are taught. Nepotism, corruption, liars and cheaters, evil people are not welcome in these universities. Your father was a scientific researcher and a teaching assistant at the University of Ottawa in 1992, and a lecturer at the University of Oradea in 1994 and 1995. While teaching at that Romanian university, your father was shocked by seeing the illegalities, the lies, and the corruption that was happening there. He was shocked discovering that most of his students did not even know how to write Romanian, let alone knowing, memorizing, or learning the subject. He soon discovered that these students have entered fraudulently in that university, that some university-leading professors have illegally sold the spots of the smart and competent young Romanians to some arrogant, imbecile and poisonous fools. Wanting to help his country, your father invited a dean from the University of Oradea to an international congress in mental training. When the dean arrived in Ottawa, your father discovered he was a crook. That Romanian dean not only wanted to steal $1,000 from your father, but his English was so bad that he could not understand almost anything that was said at that congress. So, his trip to Canada and to that congress was useless, and all these expenses with his Canadian accommodation were in vain. What was even more diabolical is that upon his arrival in Oradea, the dean gave interviews to local newspaper and told them lies after lies, trying to show how smart and important he was and about his impact on that congress. That shows again the poison in the hearts of the Romanian university professors. One other Romanian university professor told your father that he can have any woman student he wants at the University of Bucharest, where he was teaching. He said that when he saw a beautiful young woman in the university campground, he went straight to her and asked her what she was studying at that university. He then knew where to go to start his criminal act. He would go to that professor and would pay him not to pass that girl until she will sleep with him. That practice was very common in communism and continues very much even today. Romanian professors run their courses such a way that you get to their discretion. There is no objectivity in grading their students. The atrocities happening at these universities are infinite, as these poisonous and evil cockroaches do what they want there with no responsibility to no one.
Chris wants to say that. So what do you love about Ottawa or the University of Ottawa?
I like that it's bilingual and everyone's kind of involved with lots of clubs and stuff.
How about you?
For myself, I love all the parks that we have. You can just come and find like local talent and just relax or bring a textbook and hang up by a tree and read.
What do you love about the University of Ottawa?
I like that everything is close. There's a lot of things to do and it's a lot bigger than my town, so it's a lot of fun.
Where are you from?
Brunswick.
Wow, that's so cool. What do you love about the University of Ottawa?
I like how open it is and how there's actually like nature on the campus.
Nature is good. Yeah.
Yeah, everyone's pretty nice here and there's a lot of greenery here, which is nice to see. Yeah.
What do you love about Ottawa? I know you haven't been here long, but what's your impression so far?
I really like all of the rivers that you can walk along. It's very pretty and it feels like a really happy city.
Okay, fair enough. What do you love about University of Ottawa so far?
I got to live close to Abby.
Aw, that's so sweet.
Floors, because yeah. Everybody's on it. And
City of Ottawa. We are Canada's university since 1848. We are a center of national dialogue. As North America's premier bilingual university, situated next to Canada's seat of power, the University of Ottawa is a place where languages, cultures, and perspectives come together to create a unique educational experience. We are a research and policy leader. Our expertise makes us an influential player in the national policy development. Innovation and research help us create growth and prosperity for Canada. We are a key international player. At Canada's university, we play a vital role in expanding Canadian knowledge of international issues and in promoting Canadian ideas, values, and priorities on the world stage.
Since 1848, the University of Ottawa has been Canada's university.
Located in the heart of the nation's capital, the university has emerged as a vibrant center of learning with a total population of 40,000. We take pride in being a multicultural and bilingual environment. In fact, we are the largest bilingual university in North America. Minutes away from campus is the world-famous Rideau Canal, the Parliament of Canada, and the wonderful Byward Market. We have two exceptional student newspapers in French and in English. Around campus, you can find friendly student restaurants and pubs so you can relax and enjoy some time away from your books. So apply now and join our vibrant, welcoming university.
University was a place where you can experience exciting things every day, where you can learn, have fun, and meet new people. I'm still surprised by all the great things happening at the University of Alberta. I'm from Egypt, but I feel like I really fit in here. I've experienced so many amazing things since I've come, and I have great balance between my studies and my social life. And I'm sure when you come here, you'll be surprised by all the great things you experience too.
Alberta is a really beautiful place with lakes and mountains, natural parks and sites. There's nothing like it in the entire world. You really got to see it for yourself.
Edmonton has everything when it comes to the weather, but we almost always have clear blue skies. Even when it's cold, we're not stuck inside. We can go skiing, skating, and snowboarding. With over 160 kilometers of trails, it's North America's largest urban parkland and is close to university campus. It's a great place to go for a walk, hang out with friends, and even study.
I'm really glad I chose the U of A over other schools. I really like the atmosphere here, and it's a really nice place to live. As an undergraduate student, lifestyle is a very important factor of why I choose to come here. I'm able to be independent, socialize, and focus on my studies.
I came to the University of Alberta from the United States. The University of Alberta is known for its academic research, and this is one of the many reasons that I decided to come to the U of A. Students can do original research, publish it, and make a difference. My professors are understanding and knowledgeable, and my classes are interesting and relevant to my academic interests. There are many scholarship opportunities available. I received 5 scholarships. The campus is so beautiful, and there are so many great places to study, but since I have my own room in residence, I'd have to say that that's my favorite place to study.
When I first came here, I felt extremely supportive. It was easy to make friends, and I never felt alone. The International Center at U Alberta is super supportive, and it's a great place to meet new friends. There are more than 5,000 international students from 150 different countries from around the world studying here at U Alberta. International housing here at U Alberta gives you many options. At the International House, you get to mingle with Canadian and international students and share cultures and experiences together. Living on campus is super convenient. Everything I need, like grocery stores and banks, are nearby. And getting around the city is super easy on the subway or bus system.
Being part of the U of A is such a great experience. It's even better than I thought it would be. There are 39,000 students and people from all over the world. I love the diversity here.
A great thing about the U of A is there's many clubs and activities. With over 400 student groups across the 5 university campuses, there's many opportunities to meet new people and make great new friends. Another great thing about the U of A is that there's always something happening, especially in the Butter Dome, which is one of the many athletic facilities. The U of A sports teams do very well. They've won the most national championships in Canadian university athletics in the past 27 years. So if you're into sports, the U of A is definitely the place to be.
White Ave is located close to campus. Here you'll find many unique restaurants, shops, and cafes. It's the place to go to find entertainment, festivals, and arts. You'll have to check it out once you get here.
There are a lot of research centers and over 400 labs here. The University of Alberta is home to the National Institute for Nanotechnology. It is one of the few in the world, and we are proud to have it in our North Campus.
There are hundreds of undergraduate and graduate programs at the U of A. And of course, these degrees are recognized around the world.
The U of A has 236,000 alumni worldwide. Our graduates include Rhodes Scholars and artists. They have won Olympic medals, Nobel Prizes, and even Academy Awards. The U of A is not just a great university, it's an excellent one. One where you make great new friends, you'll meet old ones, you'll have fantastic experiences, and you'll also learn a bunch of new stuff. You'll be surprised what you can achieve here. Can't wait to see you here at the U of A.
University of Toronto is a fantastic place of collaboration. There's an incredible array of scholars, research activities.
Exploring the web before I came to university, I saw that the University of Toronto had three campuses, and I'm like, where should I go to? And then I saw Mississauga campus, and it was green, and I'm like, I'm going there for sure.
Downtown here on the St. George campus, I feel as if I have a community, but just a few steps outside, and I'm in the heart of the city. You certainly don't feel alone. You feel like you're part of a living system, so I love being down here.
I chose U of T Scarborough campus because I'm an athlete and I can train in the amazing facilities they have. They're made for Olympic standards and have an amazing education at the same place.
U of T is ranked in the top 20 in the world, which is excellent for me. I was born in India and I finished my high school degree in Hong Kong. So for me, it's super important to have a degree that I can use in different countries. So at U of T, getting this degree means that it's recognized all across North America, it's recognized in Asia as well, and that's something that's very valuable to me.
I wanted to pursue medicine, but when I came here,
there are so many options for me to choose from in terms of sciences. And so I ended up majoring in health and disease and pharmacology and also doing a minor in psychology.
My dream is to be an investment banker. Like, so I want to work on Wall Street. And I like the courses I'm taking right now are capital markets, investment banking, intro to introduction finance. So, you know, these courses, which I think would really be helpful in actually pursuing a career in capital markets.
I took this one particular course. There's three professors teaching 30 students, and it's three of the greatest minds I've seen. It's like you sit in a classroom with a research paper, and the person who wrote the paper is the professor in front of you. So that kind of experience you don't get at many universities.
My transition from Taiwan to Canada was really difficult, but luckily the ONES program here in University of Toronto, the class sizes were only about 20 to 25 students and also offered me a lot of writing support.
I was amazed by the fact that I could get to do research as early as my second year. And so when I saw all the options of all the things that I could research, I was really blown away.
My program right now is a double major in biochemistry and neuroscience, but U of T gave me the opportunity to explore different disciplines. For instance, we had like 5 or 6 different electives that we could choose from, and I chose among philosophy, history, psychology.
I did a religion and film course, and what I really loved about my electives is that they just challenged me to really just think about the world in a different way, and it really just changed everything that I knew, and it turned it upside down. I had no idea what to expect when I came to Toronto, but when I got here, I saw that there are so many cultures, there are so many choices, so many things to do, and I was just immediately excited.
I think in today's world, we're about global citizens. For an example, I'm doing a course right now, and it's a group project, and like in my group, there are about people from different countries, like from India, from China, from Brazil, from the United Kingdom.
Diversity is more than just diversity in culture and color. It's more about diversity in interests in Canada. You can literally be anyone in Canada.
Full life here at university. I work for the varsity as well as for the Psych Student Association, where I'm their head writer. I'm part of the Indian Student Society, the Pakistan Development Foundation, and I work at the Center for National Experience. Apart from that, I work off campus as well for the Center of Innovation and Campus Mental Health.
I'm part of several clubs and academic societies on campus. It's a great opportunity to network with different people, and that has opened so many doors for me in my career path.
I didn't know anybody when I came here. I thought I was going to be lost, but then I made a decision to live on residence, and it was one of the best decisions that I ever made.
In my first year, I lived in an apartment-style residence, so we had a lot of freedom to do our own cooking, and we used to all come together at night, and we used to have dinner together. We had this huge community feeling within our floors as well.
The residence life is actually what completed my university life, and it helped me adjust to the Canadian culture.
At any time of the day, there's always something. There are always people around. I feel very safe on campus, and I also feel safe in the city.
At my Mississauga campus, the worst that could ever happen to you in terms of threat, I don't know, maybe like a deer. It's a very safe campus.
Courses in U of T can be really demanding, but in a good way. I love the challenge, and I'm very proud of how far I've come.
I think just being at the university, there's so much promise and so much hope for me, and there's just so many places I can go and I can take it. It just feels as if there's a lot waiting for me out there.
Thank you.
I'm Stephen Toop, the President and Vice Chancellor of the University of British Columbia, Canada's global university. The university has more than 40,000 students here in beautiful Vancouver and in the beautiful Okanagan Valley. Ranked as one of the top 40 universities in the world, the University of British Columbia welcomes students and faculty from around the globe.
Leaving Turkey and moving to Canada was easier than I thought.
Moving from Connecticut to Vancouver was a very liberating experience.
People, the food, the weather especially, everything was completely different.
Canada, as far as countries to move to goes, is wonderful.
As soon as I got to Vancouver, I was really excited because I had never actually seen a city this green and this beautiful. The mountains, the ocean, it all blew me away. When I came to UBC, it made things even better.
When I first got to Kelowna, it was really warm, so lovely weather, and it suited me down to the ground because I could do all my outdoor sports, could go rock climbing with my friends all the time.
It was a big transition in one sense, but it also wasn't. I think like by the end of high school, I was very ready to move on, and I was ready to come to a place like this, I think, where it was such a mixture of what I was looking for.
I was fortunate enough to meet a lot of friends who were in the same boat as I was, living far away from home, just experiencing life at university for the first time, so that was really exciting.
I really find UBC's campus quite safe, and it has a very welcoming feeling to you. There are some really modern buildings that stood out to me when I first came to UBC, but at the same time, I could see the rich history and the culture here.
As a sciences student, I really enjoy learning here. The facilities are great for a start, and the professors are very collaborative, and it's easy to approach them outside of class.
All my profs say on the syllabus, these are my office hours, come visit, and they mean it. I've gone to my prof's office hours. The first time I was a little bit nervous, but it was a very nice conversation. Since then, I've kept on going.
One of my favorite places on campus is the International Collegiate here in the EME building. I feel like it's a great place to hang out and take a break in between classes. And I always run into friends, and we always study together here.
One of my favorite places to go to is Robson Square. It's just very vibrant, and I really like that. It's just a great place to go with your friends and just talk and have a snack or just have a good conversation.
Campus really suits my lifestyle because it's so easy to access the outdoors. Now that it's become winter, there's a whole new range of sports that are available. So the ski field is very close. We can go snowshoeing, or we can just get out camping in the winter.
Even though I'm studying here, taking advantage of what's around me is something I really want to do. Even during the week, sometimes I just need to relax for an hour or something. I go on a jog, and it's beautiful. You just run from my first year residence past the Museum of Modern Art, and there's the mountains, the sun is setting there.
One piece of advice that I would give an international student is don't hesitate when applying to UBC, because it was the best decision of my life.
I would recommend it fully. We've got a great international student program to really offer support, and Canada is a wonderful country.
The structure is here. It's all in place to get help academically, extracurricularized, socially, personally. It's just a matter of going.
Someone told me in my first year was, if by the end of your university career you felt like you accomplished something, it was because of you, because you went out there, you got out of your comfort zone, you got to experience all the opportunities that came across. You don't come to university and just go to class and go home and that's it. Like, it's what you make of it.
Education is easy. It is much easier than in Romania, because the people who are teaching are honest, humble, and very much interested in helping. If in Romania, many educators educators are so arrogant, so stupid, so imbecile, so fools, and so dangerous to their children, and would destroy the very spirit of their children. In Canada, the educators would help their children grow strong wings, to be able to fly high in the sky. If in Romania, the educators would often say, "This kid is stupid," or "That kid is incompetent." In Canada, the educators would always say, "This child doesn't learn like the others. I have to find the right method to help him learn," or "What else could I do to help him learn better and easier?" The difference is huge and is like heaven and hell. If the Canadian educational system will build healthy adults, the Romanian one will build confused, sick, manipulated and exploited adults. David, in 1995, when your father was teaching at the University of Ottawa, the cleaning lady came to him one day and asked, "Sir, please tell me what you do in your classroom, because every time I pass by your door, I hear your students all laughing." He then told her exactly what his best Canadian professors have told him many years earlier. There are many methods to teach people. Some of those methods are good, while others are bad. Stupid educators will always try to intimidate, abuse, and threaten their students, while good educators will do quite the opposite. They will treat their students with respect and dignity, and will do everything they can to create an environment that will stimulate learning. Learning while laughing is one of the best methods to learn, and your father has learned that lesson in Canada. David, your father would like you to come to Canada as soon as you can. He would like to help you to enter the University of Toronto, which is ranked 20 in the world. He would also like you to go to the University of British Columbia, which is ranked 32 in the world, or at the University of Alberta in his town of Edmonton, or at the University of Ottawa, where your father met and worked with some of the nicest, wisest and greatest people of the world. David, in this picture, you could see the 1992 top world sports psychologists and two of his professors, advisors and friends, John Somela and Terry Ordelik. The reason your father strongly recommends you to go to the University of British Columbia is because he was almost accepted in 2008 to do his PhD there. David, this is the letter of recommendation written by his recently deceased professor, advisor, and friend, Dr. John Somela. This is his letter of application for his doctorate at the University of British Columbia. competing with other 90 applicants for just 6 doctoral spots, your father was one of the last applicants to be cut. However, your father did not stop there. He continued his research throughout the next years, and the following publication includes some of his findings. He published all his major findings in the Book of Wisdom Books, book which was received very well by the Romanian readers. The reason your father is showing all these to you, David, is because he wants you to know that he would do anything he can to help you get the best education you could get. He wants to help you do that before his departure from this world. If you want to find more about his work, his books or his movies, please go online on Google and enter his Romanian name, Iobic Bota, or his Canadian name, Jordache Bota.
This next graduate started high school in Duffield, Alberta in 1939. When he got into grade 11, his father had a heart attack and he had to leave school to care for his dad to look after the family store. Walter Ross.
It's all been a good fun. It's been a long process. It's, you know, I've got 24 grandchildren now, and a dozen great grandchildren. So life is a lot of fun.
What are you going to do now that you have a high school degree? What are you going to go on to do?
Well, I'm going to learn how to speak French, and maybe learn how to play the piano, and maybe take up tap dancing.
I like it better than doing it myself. It's sharing is caring. Way better to do something with my grandpa and have a nice experience before I go off to university. I just think it's awesome that my dad graduated a long time ago, and then that way I can share it with my grandpa and me, and we can kind of full circle it.
This can be your high school. Before going to any Canadian university, you may wish to enroll. The sooner you come, the quicker will you adjust to this culture and civilization. Being a Canadian high school student is incomparable better than being a Romanian student, and that is not only because your Canadian teachers are humble, honest and better educated, and will do anything they can to help you, but also because, in Canada, you will only study what you want and need for your future, not what those disgusting, despicable and predatory Romanian teachers would ask you to do.
I'm older than you.